of the Minneapolis Senior Student Band. On behalf of Westwood Church, my name is Penny Sewell, and we welcome you to Westwood as well as to this fabulous celebration of all of these wonderful musicians. So we are very pleased to have you all here today. It's a fabulous concert, as you already have found on the program. And without any further ado, I would like to introduce the director, Emmy Stark, who's been behind the baton for all 13 of those 13 years.
Thank you. I'd like to tell you just some little fact about this band, okay? We started 13 years ago. The first year we played one concert, and we had about 27 or 28 members, and we played in the chicken ball in one corner. Now, it takes up all of the chicken ball when we rehearse. Our membership this year topped out at 104. We don't have 104 now. We have a lot of people that go south for the winter, and we're missing several today, but we still have 83 or 84 today. But we are always accepting new members. Always. Always. Including 5 minutes ago. Now, this is a disclaimer because I want you to understand something, okay? We've got the band in costume, as you can see. I said, okay, wear your basic black, but wear something to make it Halloween-y, which is what we all did. But we've got some guy back in the percussion section here that didn't get a hold of that because until 5 minutes ago, he had never played with us. Emergency, emergency, emergency. Our principal snare drummer didn't show up this morning. We have no idea where he might be. We're concerned, as always, that there was an accident of some kind. I saw Andrew come in to wish us good luck, and I said, Andrew, how'd you like to play with us this morning? This is Andrew Paulson. For those of you that don't know who Andrew is, he was just recently hired as the new director of music here at Westwood Lutheran. And we've learned from discussion that Andrew majored in percussion. So he's sight reading the concert today, and we're just very, very gracious. Glad to have you here. Okay, enough of that. Our next piece is going to be conducted by one of our associate directors, Nick Fanduzzi, and Nick has a story to tell you about this march. Nick?
Thank you, Aaron. Now, everybody dressed up, and I dressed up as a senior band director, and I figured that was scary enough. The next piece we're going to play is called March of the Steel Men. And it was composed, kind of, by Charles Belstering, it says in the program. Charles Belstering was a vice president of U.S. Steel, and he lived in the town of Joliet, Illinois. Now, this march is 80 years old. It was written in 1937. And at the time, the Joliet Township High School Band was one of, if not the very best high school band in the country. They used to have national band competitions. And Joliet kept winning. And finally they said, you know, you win all the time. Here's a really big trophy that you can put in your case. Please don't come back again so somebody else has a chance. They had this vice president. Oh, the other thing is that Joliet is the home of a very, very large steel mill, rolling mill. They make wire and everything. It's the largest wire mill in the country or something. And so they heard that the president of the company was kind of an amateur musician. He played the piano and everything like that. And the band director, being a very sharp guy, said, how would you like to write something for the band? Oh, well, sure, I can do that, you know. So he came up with this sappy waltz. Something to kind of, you know, mention all the dust in a minute. But the band director said, well, you know, you can't turn down this music from the president of the biggest company in town. So he took it to Harry Elford. Harry Elford was the biggest arranger, music publisher in Chicago at the time. He was a very hot commodity. University of Illinois and Northwestern used him to write their halftime shows. He was a big name, so they went to Harry Elford and they said, "Can you make a march out of this piece?" And he said, "Yeah. You mean I get to write a march for the best musical band in the country?" "Yeah." And so he puts everything into this march. Instead of one key change, there's four, and there's different key. It's just all kinds of stuff. We don't have room to do it, but it has downstage trumpets and downstage trombones, and it's just a fireworks march. And the last bit of the story is, of course, the Joliet Township High School band has used this as their big theme song for the last 8 years. And they have a tradition of how they play it. Well, we have, as our principal baritone player, Mr. Jim Blood, is a graduate of the Joliet High School band. Would you stand up, Jim? So I was given very specific instructions as to how to play this song. And you're in for a treat.
Thank you.
Thank you, Nick. You knew that Jim played in the Joliet band. It's wonderful. And it's so good to have Jim back. Jim went through a stroke about 6 weeks ago. And the first thing he did in his recovery was he came to play back here in the band. So we're just so happy that you're here, Jim. Now we could do one better than having a band member who was part of a march that was written. We can have one of our own members write a march, which is what the next piece is. It's called Menard's Enigma. Now, Kurt, you've never told me where the Menards comes from. Were you shopping for something one day? I don't know. But I said, where did you get the title for this march? Menard's Enigma. I said, what's the title mean? And he said, well, if I told you, it would no longer be an enigma. So we've kind of just left it at that. I want to introduce you to Kurt Larson, who wrote the next piece. Kurt? Now, this march, much like the last one, is full of different things that you would expect in a regular classic concert march or parade march. This is an enigma.
Starting with the score.
Where's your costume?
Huh? I got it,
We came in this morning and looking around at costumes, I looked over in the clarinet section and it looked like death. There he is. Stand up, Tom, so everybody can see it. Well, yeah, he's come back to life now because he's going to conduct the next piece. This is Tom Enquist. And as soon as... Okay. Even if you can't see us, we better see you. Here you go, Tom.
I'm disappointed that I can't see through that thing because I would have loved to direct it with that on. Holy man. Anyway, the next piece is Chrono Imperial. And as it implies, it is a ceremonial march played for a crowning the king, queen, or other of the special events. And the only problem that you have to figure out is when does the king or queen enter? Are there different styles? I'll let you figure that out.
Thank you.
Well, as the program said, marches and musicals. So we thought maybe in the middle we'd put the two together to kind of get the transition from marches to musicals. Meredith Wilson wrote what many consider the greatest musical ever written, The Music Man. Fun story of Harold Hill coming into this little town in Iowa and getting the whole town all upset about being in the band because they shouldn't go in the pool hall. Well, one of the great pieces in that is the 76 trombones, which we're going to play for you right now. And I told you when we did National Emblem, I said, listen to a couple of the themes of this because they're pretty well known. So when we play this arrangement of 76 trombones, see if you can recognize the themes that were taken from the National Emblem March to be part of this arrangement.
Thank you, band. Pretty fabulous, don't you think?
Yeah.
truly, truly a gift. Well, a band like this doesn't do its thing only on wings and prayers and wet wings and pumpkins. And so at this time, I'm going to invite you to think about making a contribution to the band. We are going to have ushers come forward and pass a plate so that we can help to defray the costs for supporting this wonderful band. All the music that gets written, gets reproduced, and all the time and effort that gets put into not only all the volunteer hours, but also some of the administrative tasks that people volunteer to do, but that make concerts like this a possibility. So I'm going to have the ushers come forward at this time. I would also like to extend an invitation to you to come to Westwood at other times. We worship on Sunday mornings with a traditional service at 8:45 and a contemporary service at 10:45. We have education and fellowship in the hour between the two services. We currently have been exploring the Reformation and the 500th anniversary of it, and we have been having professors from some of the local seminaries and colleges and universities come and present to us in regards to the Reformation. So we invite you to do that. On Wednesday evenings, we also have a community meal here. You are welcome to come and join us as well. Members from Westwood and many, many members from the congregation and the community, as well as our Early Childhood Center, come and share in a meal and fellowship together. Next Thursday, we also have another opportunity for you to come and support your friends or be recognized yourself if you are a veteran, if you have served in the military, and it need not have been overseas, it could have been stateside here as well, at any time in the past or currently serving. We invite you to come and to be honored in our annual Veterans Day celebration. It is a luncheon. We begin at 11 o'clock. It goes about 11 to 1. We have a very special speaker coming this year. There's music provided by the trombone ensemble, a piece of this orchestra as well. So we invite you to come and join us on that day. If you're interested in doing so, Al Ackley, who is heading up this event, will be available in the Commons following our concert here today, and he would be very happy to take your reservation. So thank you very, very much. We really do appreciate that. So I think it's time to go, like all good witches do, north, south, east, and West Side Story.
Penny, I'm the one that's supposed to be corny. I just thought of something, and that is where you're sitting and where we're sitting is all on the same level. And so you guys probably can't see all of the wonderful costumes that these guys have put so much time and thought into. So I want you to get a chance to see them. You can see the percussion section. You can see that, you know, some of them look pretty scary. And by the way, I'm happy to say that Fred, our principal snare drummer, did show up. We're going to hang on to Andrew, too. It's good having him. Okay, so, otherwise, let's go back row first. Anybody in the back row, stand up. Back row, come on, stand up. Tubas, French horns, trumpets, baritones, clarinets, stand up. Third row. Stand up. Yeah. Stand up, come on. Okay. Next row in front, stand up. Come on, row in front of that. Third row, stand up. Okay, second row, stand up. Here you go. And front row, okay. One. So, we want you to see that so that you didn't have to wonder what we're talking about. As Penny said, our next piece is West Side Story, highlights from West Side Story, and Phil Ron is going to conduct it, and look at that outfit. Say, this must be Harold Hill.
Thanks, Ed. Oh, but it's such a great pleasure to direct this band, and doing great music is really fun. West Side Story almost did not get produced because there were some things going on with Leonard Bernstein and others that were involved that almost didn't get produced. And part of what people didn't think it was, they thought it was kind of a sad story, so they didn't want to do it. But we're going to have all the great music that we have from that, such as Maria, Tonight, One Hand, One Heart, Cool, and Somewhere. So that's the songs that you're going to hear in our medley tonight. And you know, Penny was singing about welcoming, and I noticed there's a sign out there that says welcome, and it has the times. And you know what, I noticed that sometimes churches, they'll put what's going to be on the sermon for that week. And it reminded me of when Ole was he was the minister there at the Norwegian Lutheran Church, and Sven, you know, he was the pastor across the street at the Swedish Covenant, and one day they were out there putting up their signs, and Ole said, "Turn yourselves around," and Sven said, "Before it's too late." Well, just then, some teenagers came driving by in a convertible, and they said, "Oh, you crazy Scandinavians, leave us alone," and they sped off down the road. And a moment later, they hear screech and splash. And Odie turns to Sven, he says, "Maybe the sign should just say the bridge is out."
Thank you. Thank you.
One of the things that we do, which is very unusual, and I've had many of the band members say to me, this is one of the things that draws us to this band, is that we have associate conductors. We have in this band no less than 16 former music directors or conductors. At least 16. Now, they're not all conducting today. We're not going to extend the concert till 3 o'clock. But you see the names of the program of 4 of them. But it's such a joy to have trained musicians like that. But with 104 members, 16 is still, a relatively small percentage of the membership that are former conductors. But there's one thing about this band that is also very unusual. I'm going to have these people do a show of stands, not hands, a show of stands, and we'll kind of take this from the top and take it down. I'm going to stand up when I tell you this, okay? How many of you play in at least one other band? Stand up. Stand up. That's a pretty significant number, isn't it? I would say 2/3, 3/4 play in at least one other band. Now, stay standing if you play in at least 2 other bands. Sit down if you're only in one other band. These people are in at least 2 other bands. Okay, now you know where we're going from here. How many play in at least 3 other bands? We still have quite a few. How many play in at least 4 other bands? Do we dare go any further? How many play in at least 5 other bands? And after that, I call the divorce attorney. Thank you all. Our next conductor is a gentleman that I've known since I was a rookie teacher. And this will tell you something. This guy's older than I am. Where'd he hide? Oh, there he is, back there. Dick Papke was a high school band director of significance back when I started teaching in 1960, and he had already achieved quite a name for himself. So he's going to conduct this next piece, which is just kind of a wrap-up of the whole musical theme of the concert. Dick?
Today, sorry. I was very jealous of Phil's hairdo. I think I'm going to borrow that. Little fella came up and was flashing up here. That's because I'm going to go out and help my 3-month-old great granddaughter pass out trick or treats tonight. Now I really feel old when I heard the word great grand. Marvin Hamlisch was a Pulitzer Prize winning composer who gave many compositions to movie and Broadway shows. He wrote some of the best loved and most enduring songs and scores in movie history. He is one of only 12 people to win the Emmy, Grammy, Oscar, and Tony Awards. Also, he's only one of 2 people, the other Richard Rodgers, to win those 4 awards and a Pulitzer Prize. All told, he won 3 Oscars, 4 Grammys, 4 Emmys. The band will perform now a tribute to Marvin Hamlisch, which includes a medley of "They're Playing My Song," "What I Did for Love," "The Entertainer" from the movie The Sting, "The Way We Were," "One," and "What I Did for Love" from A Chorus Line, which ran on Broadway for 6,137 performances. performances. We're just going to play one tonight. We hope you enjoy this great tribute of his famous songs. Thank you.
Thank you.
just wondering, because I don't know everybody who's here, I'm wondering if there is any member of the Doan family in the audience today. Anybody from the Doan family? And I was kind of hoping somebody would be able to make it, but the next piece is dedicated to the memory of one of our really, really dependable band members who passed away this July, Dr. Bob Doan. Bob was a member of our band from our second season on, and I think every year that we presented the Perfect Attendance Awards, Bob won them. He was a charter member of the Plymouth City Band, Community Band, and the second year almost charter member of this band. And Bob was just a wonderful person. And so the next piece, Curtain Call, is for Bob. Kind of a way of saying, hey Bob, this is your curtain call. And we want you to have fun, because Bob always had fun. And this piece is meant just for fun.
Skinny on M Star. It's right here in the Lutheran Gazette, and we know every single word in the Lutheran Gazette is true. Is that right?
Yes, of course. I had a very interesting interview with Shar Stark, and she had some very revealing insights to share with us today. Now, I'm doing the talking because Shar's kind of shy. But Shar, where are you? I at least want you to stand up. Shar? There she is! Well, I'm here today with Gigi, a well-known reporter for the Westwood Lutheran Gazette. And she did indeed interview Shar and his wife to find out her thoughts about this whole senior man thing. When she first learned of Em's intents to start a senior band, was it a long-time ambition, do you think, or was it just a bolt out of the blue?
It was a bolt out of the blue.
Suddenly, he just decided to start a band. A bolt out of the blue.
Well, you know, I think I have some bolts right here. Oh, how nice. Let's see here. You know these bolty things? If you could take the top off of that M, just pull the top off that. Oh boy, good for you. We're going to put them in, put the top back on, and if you would shake that up, that'd be lovely. Thank you. Well, so Gigi, did Shar say that M had definite plans, or did it seem that he was just winging it?
No, he was just winging it.
And he was just throwing out ideas to her to see what her reaction was going to be. It was just winging it.
Well, you know, I think I have some wingy thingies right here. Little wingnuts. Could you take the top off, please? Thank you. We'll put those in. Top on, please. And shake it up. Thank you. All right. So, when Shar recovered from the shock of Em's desire to start a band, what did she really think?
He was nuts.
Well, I believe I have some nuts right here. There they are. Nice little nuts. Okay, top on. Shake it up. Thank you. And so, as the first and second years evolved for the band, what did Shar envision for this activity?
She wasn't too sure about this. She really thought it was just going to be a wash.
Well, you know, I happen to have some washers right here. And so let's throw the washers in there, put the top on, and shake, shake. Very good. Okay. So, in wrapping up this interview with Shar, what does she think about this insane idea of Em's now that she looks at this wonderful band?
Well, after 13 years, I do believe, said Shar, I think he nailed it.
And we do think that he nailed it. So if you would put, shake that up a bit, and then we do need a baton. Okay, I'll tell you, Gigi, if you could take that container from M, I'm going to give him this one. No shaking. But if you would take the baton, M, and do an abracadabra hocus pocus,
what emerges from the container. Carefully. It's like a little kid opening a gift. Okay, carefully, carefully, carefully. There you go. A little band director out of chunk. And I would like to say there is a spark plug. There is a spark plug on the top. And you know his name may be Stark, but he is actually our spark. Thank you.
These must be all the sermon notes on the floor. We'll put this up for everybody to look at when we're finished. It is really imaginative. And we'll have a place on my shelf with three or four other things like this. Really cute. Thank you very much. Okay, well, I think everybody who's here understands that this is not just a band. This is a family, and they're just absolutely wonderful people to work with, and I think that they enjoy each other, and I hope that we can continue doing this for another 13 years at least. Yeah. It was significant, I thought, that it's the 13th anniversary of Halloween. Huh? That's appropriate. So anyway, it's been wonderful. Thank you for attending. It's been so nice to have a good audience. It really has been. And come back again on the last Tuesday in October next year, because we'll be doing our 14th annual coffee concert. We're going to close with a piece that we close every concert with, The Stars and Stripes Forever.